about doing some home improvements this winter, or are you planning on upgrading your insulation as the weather gets colder, but you're not sure where to start? Well, joining me now is Robin Byrne, a Certification and Information Officer with the National Standards Authority of Ireland. He's going to talk us through the steps that homeowners need to take to avoid things going wrong. We don't want dodgy builders, Robin, that's what we don't want. Okay, so I'm thinking, right, my insulation's not up to much, I haven't done it for a couple of years, it's getting a bit colder, I need to upgrade. What are the first things I need to be thinking about?
The first thing I would do is I would check and see that your installer is NSAI registered, which is the National Standards Authority of Ireland. You can check that on our website, nsai.ie, or look with us. Those installers are also going to be grant approved. There are some grant schemes in place and some utility companies have incentives there. So one of the first instructions that they give is make sure your installer is registered.
Because I would say most people, I don't know if I'm, maybe it's just me, but you kind of go by word of mouth. You know, your next door neighbour or your best friend or somebody says to you, oh, I used your man and he was great. And that's kind of good enough. You don't really, I don't think I've ever checked out anyone who's done any work on the house. Now, it's all been great, but yeah. I've never checked anyone out, which is where we fall down massively in this country.
It is, and just because it's a cash job doesn't mean it's going to be a bad job.
Yeah.
But it means that there's a lot more protection if you use registered installers, because there'll be warranties, there'll be formal contracts in place. There'll also be independent assessment of those installers, and that the products they use have been certified and assessed for Irish building conditions and the Irish building regulations. So you've a lot more protection there than just the word of mouth cash job.
And do you see some awful botch jobs, Robin? I mean, you must have people coming to you tearing their hair out.
We do, unfortunately.
When it comes to insulation, what are the biggest kind of issues that you see?
The main things, I suppose, would be, well, that's a particularly bad example you're showing there, where there was no water management. You've got bees coming out through a meter box there where the wall wasn't properly inspected.
That was bead. Oh,
bead. That's blistering a delamination of the render surface. That's just a poor attempt at putting in an oversill and trying to patch it up by throwing some stones down. Unprotection insulation at water. Basically, poor water management, not closing things off. That's just a basic. We usually put an elbow or detail in there rather than have a weak point at the junction for cracks. And again, poor attention to details, basically sloppy work and lazy work.
I'm assuming when that sloppy or lazy work has been done, 9 times out of 10, there's no comeback for those people.
There won't be unless you have a formal contract in place. There's no comeback at all.
So say my friend says to me, oh, Jimmy's great, he'll sort your insulation out. And Jimmy comes down and I say to Jimmy, right, I want a formal contract. How do you go about putting that into place?
Just ask him straight out.
Yeah.
And say, you know, okay, when can I see a quotation for the work? And rather than just getting a number on a piece of paper, get him to fully specify the works that he's going to be carrying out for you. And also, what are your responsibilities on that job? You may have to provide electricity. It'll be your responsibility to talk to your energy provider, like Gas Networks Ireland, the Bord Gáis Electricity, in terms of moving meter boxes. If there's electric cables to be moved, even getting permission from the neighbour sometimes if they have to put scaffolding and bridging onto their property. And, you know, realistically, our registered installers will give a full formal quotation, and homeowners should be requesting that across the board.
So the only way to be 100% sure is to make sure they are registered?
Basically.
And how many installers, when it comes to insulation and other things, are registered in the country? Is it the majority?
Probably not. I mean, we have about 250 over full fill cavity wall insulation and external insulation.
That's not very many, is it?
It's not really.
Yeah.
And it has dropped, obviously, since the downturn of the construction industry.
Yeah.
A lot of people went over to the UK or just couldn't compete anymore. So it is quite a small number, but at the same time, that makes it easier to control because we audit them annually. And while we can't get to every job, obviously, we do get a good sample size.
And when it comes to making complaints, say somebody is registered and you feel like, well, he hasn't done what he said he was going to do, what is the complaints procedure?
Well, the first port of call for a homeowner to have an issue is the installer themselves. If they're not getting satisfaction there, they can also contact the certificate holder, the material supplier, and then they can also talk to NSAI, and we will look at the complaint and try and encourage the installer and the certificate holder to engage with the homeowner and achieve a proper solution.
Should you ask for references almost?
Always.
Yeah.
You should always ask for 3 quotations, and any quotation that you get, you should always ask for names and addresses of clients that they've done work for in the area, and go and visit those properties, not just see the outside, but talk to the homeowner, ask the homeowner what was their experience of the installer.
Because you see, really, that's people just being lazy, thinking, God, that sounds like an awful lot of work. I just want someone to come in and fix what I need fixing.
It does,
yeah.
But you're spending a lot of money. This is thousands of euro that you're spending with external insulation. it could be maybe 12,000 to 15,000 euro.
And do you see an awful lot of these cases ending up in the small claims courts or ending up in, you know, monetary disagreements? Because an awful lot of people pay up front, which you were saying to me is don't ever do that.
Please don't. I mean, I'll agree stage payments with the installer. Don't pay anything up front. And again, put that in the formal contract so everybody's in agreement. We don't have any statistics in terms of the small claims court because usually that wouldn't come to us.
Okay, Robin, thank you very much. Great advice.
Thank you.
Now we're going to take a break, but lots more to come. So stay with us here on Ireland AM. See you in a few.